Well, last week, government announced that our national unemployment rate fell 1.1% to 6% last quarter, the first time it's dropped in more than 2 years.
However, that's not the case with our own Pacific Islands unemployment, which is on the way up. Adrian Stevenon has more.
Thanks, Tom. That's right. The unemployment rate for the March quarter actually went up 0.4%, meaning an extra 1,300 Pacific people found themselves without a job. John Otunga's been crunching the numbers and has the story.
5 months ago, 3,000 people applied for just 160 jobs at a South Auckland supermarket. Among the unlucky ones that day was 18-year-old Elijah Seomanu.
I thought the problem with unemployment was pretty small, but then when I went for the interview, it's bigger. It's bigger than what it seems.
Elijah's still looking for work. He left school 2 years ago to help support his parents. He did temp work, but now wants a full-time job.
It's been pretty hard, because just all the rejections and, you know.
A year ago, 13.6% of our workforce was unemployed. Right now, that figure's 14.4%, well over double the national average.
So what does 14.4% unemployed look like? Well, if they threw a rock concert for all our Pacific unemployed here at the Vector Arena, capacity 12,000, 3 months ago they would have packed it out with standing room only. Today, there'd be an extra 1,100 people waiting outside in the cold.
On the job front, unions are still seeing layoffs. They say it's an employer's market and they're just not hiring as quickly as they used to.
I think there's a role of the government to really look at some sort of focus and emphasis around Pacific and Māori. I mean, one in three Pacific and Māori youths are not in jobs. And, you know, this is the future of our workforce.
So just why are our numbers trending up? Economists say it's got to do with our community profile. Most of our unemployed are young with little qualifications.
We need to turn around that behaviour for the younger age groups around leaving school early or leaving school with no training or no qualifications, because in today's world and in tomorrow's economy, those sorts of people have no future.
Meanwhile, job hunting continues for Elijah. He's applied for 30 jobs and only got one interview in 3 months.
Living paycheck to paycheck, you know, only my mum's working, so it's been really tough on our family. It's a struggle.
Putting bread on the table, still a tough ask for this 18-year-old.
Joining me now to talk more about unemployment is the Minister of Social Development and Employment and Minister of Youth Affairs, Paula Bennett. Thank you very much for coming in to talk on the show today.
Yeah.
Firstly, let's talk about the numbers. Overall, the country's unemployment numbers are going down, which is good. Pacific Island numbers still going up. What do you think that is?
Yeah, slightly going up in that last quarter. I think it is a combination of the demographics. So we're younger. Our Pacific people are generally younger. There is that sort of semi to low skilled. I reckon that it's Auckland based. So many of our Pacific people live in Auckland, and Auckland has been hard hit by this recession, and its recovery is quite slow. So if I compared it to Māori are sort of, you know, spread throughout New Zealand a little more evenly. They get the pick-up in seasonal work. Pacific Islanders have not had that same opportunities.
Some of the unions are saying the government should be doing more about, Pacific Islands unemployment. What is the government doing to help our Pacific Island unemployment?
Yeah, look, we introduced Community Max, which, you know, had about a 6% take-up from Pacific, for Pacific people. We certainly, job ops, we're seeing about 10% of them going to Pacific peoples as well. But it's been quite a focus through work and income in particular to make sure that we're trying to get those sorts of training opportunities, those sorts of upskilling opportunities through work and income, and we've put more of an investment in that to try and help Pacific people so that they can go and get those jobs.
Because Labor has criticised the government for, they say that they've done, well, the Minister's done, of Pacific Island Affairs has done little or if anything, to help tackle the problem. They also say that cutting adult community education courses by 80% and cutting the training incentive allowance for beneficiaries hasn't made things easier for our people to upskill in this time. I mean, is that fair cop?
Well, I just think it's a very sort of simplistic argument for what is quite a complex sort of issue. The reality is, if the jobs aren't there, we can't put people into them. So we have a responsibility to try and, you know, get this economy boosting again, to get businesses feeling like they can take people on, and particularly in areas like South Auckland, which have been some of the hardest hit, and as a consequence has had a big sort of repercussions for Pacific people. So it is about getting that sort of environment right, giving them confidence, and giving them some of those sorts of subsidies, which we've done as well, which will encourage them to take young people and Pacific peoples on.
I guess the question is then, Minister, what do you do if you're one of these 16,600 that's everyone who identifies themselves as being Pacific Island, that is unemployed at the moment. Mm. What do you do if you're in their position?
Yeah, look, I mean, you certainly try and make yourself more employable, and that is by trying to upskill and get more skills under your belt. You know, you do front up, and I know there's queues for some jobs, but look at perhaps what some of those long-term goals of yours might be. If possible, I agree with the stay in school. You know, stay in school. It is the best sort of start you can get, the best sort of credentials you can give to an employer is that you've stuck there longer. Get some assistance with writing your CV and making sure that it's presentable and perhaps gets you an interview, because that's a first start. And then when you do get there, tell them everything that is great about you. You know, sometimes we're a little bit shy and don't want to sort of put our best foot forward, and I think some of our Pacific people can be like that a bit more. I say, tell them you're honest, tell them you're going to front up, tell them you want it.
Okay, but I mean, are you concerned about the one in three under 20 that, you know, are actually sitting idle?
Hey, I lose sleep over this stuff. You know, I care more about this than just about anyone. I'm the Minister of Employment.
Right.
You know, I'm proud to say that more than half of those coming off the unemployment benefit are young people, but we have got a long way to go. You know, I mean, I've got 60,000 people on the unemployment benefit. I want that number to be so low. Job opportunities for everyone is our goal. Unfortunately, I don't have that magic wand to make it happen overnight.
Finally, Minister, I mean, so if you are one of those people, do you have anything to say to that number, you know, the 16,000 Pacific Island unemployed, you know, people like Elijah who want a job but they just can't get one? Yeah. Do you have any hope for them?
Oh, I have incredible hope for them, because we're already seeing things get better, but I'm not going to pretend that we haven't got a long way to go and that it hasn't been hasn't felt some pain for a lot of our individuals and families. So we do have to get through this bit of a rough patch to get to a place where there are more jobs available. So I don't want to undermine what they're going through. But I think there is, unfortunately. You know, we can't create that number of jobs overnight, but I think we're heading in the right direction. I say keep hope and keep going, because we're backing them.
All right, Minister, thank you very much.